This morning I've been called out to this newly refurbished swimming pool. It was all working a few days ago and now nothing's working. What has been done, you've got this little box there. That's a vacuum switch to operate the pumps and various other relays and heaters and stuff. I'll take you down to the control room and we'll have a look and see what we found there. And we've got a couple of pumps and filters. We've got pump number two, pump number one, pump switches there, and then we've got the main control board here. First of all, we go to the consumer unit there, and I've just tested to make sure that there's power there and everything, and there's a light in here as well that's working. So I found the breakers and just checked those first, and again there's power going through to each one. I've then found this armored cable here that then I thought was a feed for the control box, and it's not actually a feed for it. If you look, it goes outside there. So I was just looking at that because I didn't know what that one was. Wrapped up behind here, was in a plastic bag, and that's what I found. So straight away I was thinking, that doesn't look very good. Again, that's just a switch that apparently, when the pool was refurbished a couple of years ago and the new building was done, this was just left up in a plastic bag. Switch was left in the on position and just tucked behind there. There's various contacts, a couple of MCBs there, some contacts down here. And all I did, this twin and earth cable here, I just tested power there, just put my probes on there, and again, that was live. So that was all okay. I then looked at the control board and again found this cable here. And again, this cable here is this one here. So all of these controls here, and then various red wires come off there to control cables for various things in here. These three contacts are the three pumps. So we've got pump down there, we've got a little pump here, and we've got a pump here. And it's these things that aren't working, and they are controlled from this control panel here. I can just override this, so you can hear one pump has come in, you can hear another pump has come in, and again, so all three motors or pumps, whatever you want to call them, all three are working. The thing is that's not working though is A1 and A2 on each one, they're the coil controls. And in these case, they're 230 volt or 240 volt coil controls. So again, it's these things that you need to operate from, say for example, that board. The coil will energize and pull the contact in. So it's A1, which is the, I need to work out why that's not working. To make sure that the A1 or A2 are okay. Well, we know that A1 looks like it's the live side, and it looks like A2 is the neutral side. But that's not necessarily the case, so I had to check that. So I just probed on between A2 and the incoming live, and again, I've got 230 volts there. I know that the coil, the neutral to the coil, is okay. So straight away, I'm looking at A1 on each one, and I can, we need to basically get those live. I tried not to take too many cables out because it just becomes really messy and stuff like that. So again, we've got all these covers here, and all of these covers obviously clip on, and it all looks nice and neat. And you can see I've pulled a couple of cables out anyway. Now, we've got this cable here. And again, as soon as I opened the box up, this goes on to one of these contacts here, but it wasn't connected. And so I haven't bothered trying to reconnect that because it wasn't connected before, and I didn't think that was what the problem was. Again, we've got the wooden box the other side by the swimming pool, and this is the vacuum switch that can be operated from that pump there to bring on the pumps as well. That works on a vacuum. Again, it just makes the contacts there, which then controls everything else. But that wasn't really the issue. So what I've done then is I've traced the cables. So I know I've got power here. It goes into there. So basically I checked this fuse, and I just checked whether power was coming through, and so I just probed onto the other side, and yes, it was coming through. And then you can see I've been tracing where the wires go. Foolishly, as I was looking at this, and it's a mistake I made, because they haven't got wires, there's no feeds going into the tops, I then foolishly assumed that these three contacts weren't working. And so I've been doing all this, everything else, and then it then suddenly occurred to me that maybe all of these ones are working, and maybe that's what the problem is. This one was in there, just like that. And so when I probed onto that one, it wasn't live, nothing was there. I pulled it out and had a little 3 or 5 amp, I think it's a 3 amp, but actually it's a 15 amp fuse, it was my mistake. I wasn't paying attention too much. So had the system running nicely, just testing it, making sure everything works. And then suddenly, pop, it goes wrong again. So I've just changed the fuses around now. So I have put a 15 amp fuse back in here, and I've just put the 5 amp fuse back into this one on the control circuit. One of the things I did pick up with the customer this morning is if you look at this cable and this cable, not so much on these ones, but you can see they're quite dark, so they obviously use quite a bit of current. So these are the contacts for the pool heaters. And again, they're both controlled by individual 32 amp circuit breakers. So we've got the pumps. This is a manual or automatic. It was on auto. And then you've got the two heaters. You've got a spa heater and the pool heater. So again, if we just operate the system, and that's the pumps, you'll see that brings on these three contactors. And again, you'll see, you'll notice before, I manually overrode those, which you can do, but it's that button there is controlling the coils A1 and A2 on each contactor. So if I press the spa heater, the pumps have to be running. So if I press the spa heater, and you'll see that contact now comes through. Again, it's A1 and A2, controls the 240 volt coil, brings in the main contactor. That's the spa heater. Turn that off. Now I'll turn on the pool heater. And again, that brings that on. So it's the control. I'll turn them off. At the moment, everything seems to be working.